إن الحمد لله رب العالمين نستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Verily all praise is for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help and His forgiveness. We believe in Him and place our trust in Him and Him alone. And I seek refuge with Allah from the evil of my actions and from myself. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can misguide him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah leaves in error, there is none that can guide him after Allah. I testify none is worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final prophet and messenger for all time to come. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatihi wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Ya ayyuha an-nasu taqu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida wa khalaqa minha zawjaha wa batha minhuma rijalan kathiran wa nisaa'a. Wa taqullaha alladhi tasa'aluna bihi wal arham. Inna allaha kana alaykum raqiba. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. O you who believe, have taqwa of Allah, to be mindful, conscious and fearful of Allah, the taqwa that is due to Him, and do not die unless you are Muslim. O humanity, reverence your guardian Lord, who has created you from a single person, and from him his mate, and from them too many men and women. And fear your Lord, through whom ye demand your mutual rights, and respect the ties of kinship and the wombs that bore you. And Allah is an ever watcher over you. O you who believe, have taqwa of Allah, to the best of your ability, the taqwa that is due to him, and always say a word directed to the right, for he will forgive you your sins and set aright your affairs. And whoever obeys Allah and his messenger has indeed gained a marvelous achievement. Amma ba'd. Fa'alum inna khayr al-kalam kalamullah. Wa khayr al-hajji hajju Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa shar al-umuri muhdathatuha wa kulli muhdathatun bid'a. Wa kulli bid'atin dalala wa kulli dalalatin finnar. As to what follows, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enshrined in His noble book Al-Quran, about which Allah azza wa jalla has said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That is the book in which there is no doubt. It is a guide for those who do have the taqwa. This is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about whom Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَيَوْمِ الْآخِرَةِ وَذَكْرَ اللَّهِ كَثِيرًا. That verily in the Messenger of Allah, you have the most excellent model, the most excellent example for him whose hope is in meeting Allah in the last day and who remember Allah much. And we must know that the worst of affairs are the newly invented matters or innovations in religion. For every innovation, every addition to or subtraction from the deen of Islam, as it was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and conveyed to his companions, may Allah be pleased with all of them, and passed down to the successive generations, the tabi'een and the atba'i tabi'een. Any alteration or change from that is a wicked going astray, and every going astray is in the hellfire, and from that we seek Allah's protection. Walhamdulillahi alladhi ja'alna min al-muslimin. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has made us Muslims, and we thank Allah azza wa jalla for giving us another opportunity to earn a measure of His forgiveness. For indeed, Yawm al-Jum'ah is Yawm al-Maghfirah, a day of forgiveness. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has said that Friday is the best day that the sun has shined on. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. It's sad that the people of the book, our cousins, they have only one Friday they call good. But for the Muslims, alhamdulillah, every Friday is the good Friday, because every Friday is the best day on which the sun has shined. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that this is the day that our father Adam alayhi salam was created and placed in the Jannah. It is the day that he was taken out of the Jannah, and it will be the day on which Yawm al-Hisab, Yawm al-Qiyamah. the day of resurrection and standing before Allah will take place. And we seek Allah's protection from the dread, the torment, the terror of that hour. Ameen. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Ya Ikhwa wa Akhwati fil Islam. We want to talk today about one of the commandments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wherein Allah has commanded the Muslims to command the good. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas ta'maruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. He has commanded us, first identifying what is the essence of the Muslim ummah. And he says that you are the best of people brought out from humanity and for humanity. You are the best of people brought out for humanity because you command the good and you forbid the evil and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from doing this, from this commandment, from the fulfillment of this commandment, is an obligation that all of us as Muslims have, and that is to be du'at, to be callers, to be inviters to Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in Surah Al-Fusilat, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلُ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And who is better in speech than one who calls to Allah and who does the good deeds and who says, I for sure am of the Muslims. So this is the obligation that we have today, to be du'a, regardless of what our chosen field of profession is, regardless of what our responsibilities are in our daily lives, in our workplace, or in our family life, in our academic life. The first and foremost responsibility that we have after li'abudun, after worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to tell others about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to tell others about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be du'a. Sometimes the question comes, the question is put forth, is da'wah and being a da'i for Islam, is it an obligation? Is it fard? And our scholar, the great Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Baz, rahimahullah, he says that the call to Islam, the work of da'wah, is fard ain, and it is fard kifaya. It is both an obligation on the individual Muslim, and it is a collective obligation. Especially in the time that we're living in, when Islam is under such great attack, when Muslims are being stigmatized and being made to be the object of fear and suspicion, it is especially incumbent upon us to take on the responsibility of being callers to this way. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So we hope, inshallah ta'ala, that our visit during this weekend here in Santa Clara will be a game changer here in Santa Clara, but all across the country, because something historic has taken place within the last 17 months that maybe many of you don't know about. For too long now, we have not had a unified voice of Islam here in America. For too long, we've been allowing non-Muslims to tell the story about what is Islam and who are the Muslims. And sadly, the story is often misrepresented. And so, consequently, many people, in their ignorance, they fear Islam. They fear the Muslims. They slander our beloved Nabi wa Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because they don't know. Because they've been spoon-fed lies and misinformation. Well, today, alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed us with a voice in the media. And we need to use the media. Just like the non-Muslims use the media to get their message across, we need to be using the media to get our message across. So today, alhamdulillah, we're broadcasting the khutbahs and the programs throughout the weekend live on Guide US TV. And I believe US does need guidance. But if you want to say guide us, that's fine. Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. What does it mean to be a da'i, from the callers of Islam? Does it mean that you have to be an alim, that you have to have a degree, an ijazah, or a certificate in calling to Islam? Absolutely not. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, to teach the Quran, even if it's only one ayat, only if all you know is قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, teach the people that, because most of the people in the world don't know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't know what is their purpose for being. You ask the average person walking up and down the street, why are you here? They'll tell you they're here to get a job. They'll tell you they're here to complete their education, or they're in the grocery store to purchase some groceries. But no, that's not the real question. The real question is, why are we here on this earth? And no one had the answer for that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created us. And he has given us that answer very clearly in Quran when he says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I have not created the jinn or the human being except for my worship. This is the purpose for which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. And the people need to know this. Who else can tell them that except the Muslims, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. So dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are here to encourage all of us to step up to the plate. I'm using the colloquial term of American English when we talk about stepping up to the plate, just like in baseball, when the batter goes up to the plate to hit a home run or to get a hit so that it'll help his team win. We need to step up to the plate of da'wah and increase our responsibility, increase our commitment to help convey this message of Islam, walhamdulillah. Walhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. We are in a very political season right now. And Islam and Muslims will be one of the balls that are kicked around to make the voting populace go one way or the other. If you recall, in the last election, prior to the election, November 2008, we saw a big effort by some organizations to defame and to demonize Islam and Muslims. So they published a DVD and they put it in all of the major newspapers and sent them out all across the country to try to sway the vote a certain way. Well, 4 years later, we've come to find that the one who was elected is really a one side in this experimental democracy. You see, there's a lot of talk about outlawing the Sharia. You see, these are very, very serious questions that we need to be dealing with. Because if we're not answering these questions, if we're not addressing these concerns, then for sure we're going to let our communities go down the drain. We're going to let our communities be controlled by interests that do not have Islam and Muslims at heart. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that all of us will heed the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be of those who are best in speech, to call to the way of Allah, and who do the amalu salihat, which are the deeds according to the Quran and the Sunnah, the authentic Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Listen to what our beloved Nabi Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said on the authority of Abu Mas'ud Uqbah ibn Amr al-Ansari al-Badri radiallahu anhu, who reported, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, what means in English, whoever guides someone to virtue will be rewarded equivalent to him who practices that good action. On the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he reported Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam as saying, if anyone calls others to follow right guidance, his reward will be equivalent to those who follow him in righteousness, without their reward being diminished in any respect. And if anyone invites others to follow error, the sin will be equivalent to that of the people who follow him without their sins being diminished in any respect. So for sure, those of us who can write guidance, who invite to Islam, alhamdulillah, imagine you teaching someone how to recite Al-Fatiha, teaching someone how to make wudu', teaching someone how to read Alif Lam Mim. And every time that person recites Al-Fatiha, every time that person makes wudu', every time that person reads Quran, you will get the same reward that he gets without it being diminished in any way. Allahu Akbar. This is truly, truly a magnificent reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the problem, dear Muslims, the problem is not in the message. Believe me, it's not in Islam, it's not in Quran, it's not in the Sunnah. The problem is within our own selves. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Let us ask Allah for forgiveness. Wa inna Allaha ghafoor rahim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As-salatu as-salam ala Rasul al-Kareem. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, that declaration of faith that we make so frequently throughout the day and throughout the course of our lives, the one which we hope to die with on our tongue with, that when Allah calls us back, when the angels of death come to take our souls, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us among the steadfast and recite the kalima la ilaha illallah wa Muhammadan Rasulullah at that time. This kalima is the greatest oath that we can take in this life, even greater than the oath that you would take in the highest court of the land. And we know that when we go to the maqbir, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to send those angels to question us, to ask us, who is your Rabb? Who was your prophet? And what was your deen? And we may think that it's easy to say Allah is our Lord and Muhammad is our prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Islam is our deen. But if we have not been living that in this life, we won't be able to say it. Because our actions have to be in accordance with what we say. Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ كَبْرَ مَقْتًا إِنَّ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ O you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do? It is most hateful in the sight of Allah that you say what you don't do. So we have to be one with this word that we proclaim. Our greatest enemy is not outside of the ummah. It is not the Zionists or the Nasara or the Kafir or the Mushrik. Our greatest enemy is our own selves. Our unwillingness to shoulder the responsibility of carrying. Our unwillingness to see beyond our own immediate existence. Do you know that there are non-Muslims right now planning for our community 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 50 years from now, 100 years from now? They have over a 500-page document studying the Muslims all throughout the world, 50 years in advance. All you have to do is go to rand.org. It's there. If you want to waste the paper and the ink, you can print it out yourself. Authorized by the United States Air Force, no less. Why aren't we doing studies like this? Why did it take a non-Muslim some 30-odd years ago to write a book called The 100 Most Influential Men in History, who identified Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the most influential man in history? You see, we are leaving the work of da'wah to those who are not qualified to convey the message because they don't live it. You and I live it, but somehow we have become intimidated. Somehow we have been made to be afraid to tell others about Islam. Maybe we're afraid that we'll lose our job. Maybe we're afraid we'll lose our academic credentials. Maybe we're afraid we'll lose our citizenship. Maybe we're afraid we'll lose our green card if we speak up too much. La ilaha illallah. What are we afraid of? The Muslim is only supposed to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And any fitna that we can experience today would never measure up to the fitna that the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam experienced. So if we have experienced a little bit of hardship because we're inviting to the way of Islam, don't break under that pressure, because greater men and women than you and I have experienced much worse in the way of persecution, suffering, and hardship. Alhamdulillah. All we have to do is look at our noble companions, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to be reminded of the suffering that they went through. How Ka'b ibn al-Arat, may Allah be pleased with him, was made to wear a coat of metal in the heat of the sun, to the point where it boiled his skin, and his skin became like liquid fat. Where our mother, Sumaya, one of the believers, The first martyr was killed in a very heinous way. And yet we worry about the little trials that we have faced, that we're going to lose our green card, we're going to lose our citizenship. No. We should fear nothing but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. America, alhamdulillah, will be a much better place if Islam were to be established like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends for it to be. Don't let anyone tell you that there's no place for Islam in America. That there's no place for the Sharia in America. That there's no place for Muslims in America. They come and they tell me, you need to go back where you came from. Oh yeah, I'm from D.C., where you want me to go? And the audacity of them to say that Islam has no place when the very first country to recognize the sovereignty, the independence of the United States was none other than a Muslim country, Morocco. Allahu Akbar. So don't tell me that Islam does not belong here. This earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our love for him and his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our love for this deen and even more our love for one another. We need to rise above the petty differences that we allow to cause division in our ummah. The ethnic divide that sometimes puts one race against another. The Arab against the non-Arab. The white against the black. We're coming up on Ramadan, alhamdulillah. We should be preparing for that. But it saddens me to see the masjid, after being so filled up during Ramadan, it becomes an abandoned house once the Eid is over. It saddens me to see, after the glorious celebration of the Eid, that we fall into our little nationalistic or ethnic tribal groupings to celebrate the Eids. No, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَا تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تُحَابُوا. He said that you will not enter Jannah until you believe, and you will not believe until you love one another. And he said, may I show you a way that will increase the love among you? He said, أَفْشُوا السَّلَامُ بَيْنَكُمْ. Spread the saying of the salam, spread the greetings, to say it with meaning, السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ. This is a dua. We're calling on Allah salam to give one another peace. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help rectify the affairs of the Muslim. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower his forgiveness upon the Muslims all over the world, wherever we have fallen short. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our resolve, increase our commitment to spread this message of Islam. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower his choices, peace, mercy, and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر لي ولكم أقم الصلاة